A student at York University is calling for more support for young adults who have a terminally ill family member because she knows what it's like and she feels that provision is poor.
So she's enlisted the help of Fixers, the campaign that gives young people a voice, to help fill the gap.
If you could choose a mum, she'd be a brilliant mum to pick from. And since she's become ill, I think I appreciate what she's always done for me more, and I appreciate her little quirks a bit more and the time that she can give me more. I realise how special she is and how lucky I am to have had such a fantastic mum for all of my life. I'm Naomi Barrow, I'm 21 and I'm a student in York. I am working with Fixers to support other young adults who have a family member who's terminally ill. My mum was first diagnosed with breast cancer in summer 2012, just after I'd finished my A-levels. In February 2014, she was diagnosed with terminal cancer. Rather than talking to people, I logged into the internet and Googled parent terminal illness. And I found loads of support for under 18s and for parents of terminally ill children, but I didn't find any support for people my age in this situation. And that's so isolating. You just sit there in front of your screen and your mum's dying and you're in a university room and your friends are pre-drinking and you're sat there like, I just want someone else who understands. It's just not there. So I just want to let young people in my situation know that they're not alone. And I also want the people around those young people to know that any support they're giving that young person is valid and is really, really needed.
There is a gap in provision for young adults that are going through similar situations to Naomi. It is such a vulnerable time because that transition into adulthood is difficult even if you're being supported, but if you haven't got the support and you're tackling issues such as terminal illness within the family, it can be even more difficult.
My dad isn't the same dad I used to have. He doesn't sound like him, doesn't look like him. In my head he's still there, but everything's changed.
Today I'm talking to Kayla Laysby and Kia Bale. Kayla's dad has terminal cancer and Kia's mum died 3 years ago also of cancer.
My mum was quite, she wanted me to kind of live my life and go ahead and do all my stuff and go to uni, and I think that was really difficult because I wanted to please her, but then I also wanted to spend time with her.
Do you think that there is anything that would help people in our situation?
I guess talking about it with people that have experienced it, it like struggled a lot with talking to people because they were like, I understand what you're going through and you don't understand, so talking to people about it, that going through it helps so much more.
I feel like I had no preparation for when she died, and I think that's a completely different battle which you're going to have to face at some point, and which is horrible, but that's the kind of support which you need.
Yes, it's difficult and it's horrible and I hate it, but I think I'm so lucky to be able to spread this awareness about this issue, because without this kind of thing, we just wouldn't be able to talk about it. So I think it's an amazing opportunity.
And to see more about this story and Fixers, or to find where you can get help on this issue, just visit fixers.org.uk/terminalcare.